everyone is unique, whether she's shy or extroverted, tall or short, single or a mother of five. But there is one issue that can affect us all, breast cancer. 13,000 Australian women are diagnosed with breast cancer every year. That's one in eight women in their lifetime. Breast cancer is not a disease that you should be afraid of, but it is a disease that you should be aware of. It's important to know the facts. Breast cancer occurs when abnormal cells in the milk ducts, or lobules, of the breast grow out of control. These abnormal cells can then invade the surrounding breast tissue. If left untreated, cancer cells in the breast tissue can break away and spread to other parts of the body via the bloodstream or lymphatic system. Unfortunately, we don't know what causes breast cancer or how to prevent it. We do know that the hormone estrogen plays a role, which is why it's a disease that mainly affects women. And research shows us there are some things that increase the chance of developing breast cancer. These are called risk factors. Well, if you're a woman, then unfortunately you're at risk of breast cancer, as this is the strongest risk factor, and this risk increases as you grow older. In fact, 3 out of every 4 cases of breast cancer occur in women aged 50 years and over. Although breast cancer can occur at any age, only 6% of cases are in women under 40 years. Another risk factor is having a family history of the disease. Now, as it's such a common cancer, many women will have a relative with breast cancer simply by chance. But if you have 2 or more relatives with breast cancer on the same side of the family, you may be at an increased level of risk. About 5% of all breast cancers can be explained by an inherited gene fault. It's best to talk to your GP if you have any concerns about your family history of breast cancer. Things that increase your exposure to estrogen can slightly increase your risk of breast cancer. However, the level of estrogen in your body is not something you can always control. Starting your periods relatively early, say before the age of 12, and experiencing menopause relatively late, after the age of 55, extends the length and time you're exposed to the estrogen produced by your ovaries. Putting on a lot of weight after menopause and, believe it or not, drinking more than 2 glasses of alcohol a day also increases the amount of estrogen in your body. And things like taking the contraceptive pill or combined hormone replacement therapy also increase your risk. On the other hand, there are some things that either decrease or interrupt your exposure to estrogen that can slightly lower your risk of breast cancer, like having children before the age of 30 years and breastfeeding. While we can't guarantee that any one woman will never get breast cancer, there are some lifestyle changes you can make to lower your risk. Regular brisk exercise reduces risk of breast cancer for women of all ages. And the more exercise you do, the better. It's also a good idea to maintain a healthy body weight, especially after menopause, and keep your alcohol intake down to 2 or less drinks per day. But it's important to remember that many women who develop breast cancer have no obvious risk factors, and most women with 1 or more risk factors will never develop the disease. You might have heard the rumours that some everyday things can cause breast cancer, so let's get the facts straight. Wearing a tight or underwire bra will not cause breast cancer, neither will stress, wearing antiperspirant deodorant, or receiving a knock or bump to the breast. Since we can't prevent breast cancer, finding it early is the key to living a long and healthy life after the disease. Let me show you why. Take these 2 groups of 100 women diagnosed with breast cancer. 100 of these women have their breast cancer diagnosed early while it is still confined to the breast. If we follow them up 5 years later, more than 90 of these women will be alive and well. Compare that with another group of 100 women whose breast cancer was not detected early and has already spread to other organs in their body at the time they are first diagnosed. Only about 25 of these women will be alive 5 years later. The earlier breast cancer is found, the better the chances of surviving the disease. So the big question is, what can you do?
Be breast aware.
That's right.
How?
It's easy. There's actually no special technique, no right or wrong way to do it. The National Breast Cancer Centre recommends breast awareness for every woman as part of everyday life. That means simply getting to know the normal look and feel of your breasts through everyday activities like showering, dressing, putting on moisturiser, or even just looking in the mirror. Knowing what's normal for you will help you recognise new or unusual breast changes. If you do notice something that's not normal for you, it's important to see your GP without delay. Remember, no one knows your body like you do. The changes that you need to look out for are a change in the size or shape of your breast, a new lump or lumpiness, especially if it's only in one breast, a change to the nipple, such as crusting, ulcer, redness or inversion where the nipple turns in, a nipple discharge, a change in the skin of your breast, such as redness or dimpling, or an unusual pain that just doesn't go away. 9 out of 10 breast changes won't be due to cancer, but only a doctor can tell. So see your GP about anything that's new or unusual for you. Screening mammograms are the best tool we have for finding breast cancer early in women aged 50 years and over who have no other signs or symptoms of the disease. These x-rays of the breast tissue can pick up a breast cancer in its early stages, when it's very small and appears as a white spot. But mammograms are not as effective in younger women. We all know our breasts change as we get older, and our breasts look different on a mammogram as we age too. It's very difficult to see any early signs of cancer on a younger woman's mammogram. Talk to your GP about whether you should be having regular screening mammograms. But remember, it's important that you are breast aware and know the normal look and feel of your breasts even if you're having regular mammograms. The good news is more and more women are surviving breast cancer than ever before. As individuals, we have a vital role to play in our own breast health. And as women, we can encourage our mothers, sisters, daughters and friends to be breast aware too. So please pass this DVD on to the women you care about. It could save a life. If you'd like more information on anything you've heard today, talk to your GP or visit the National Breast Cancer Centre's website.